Dear colleagues, I want to speak with you today as we enter our second lockdown. In what has already been a very difficult year, this return to a lockdown is a blow to us all. For the second time in a month, we will have to adjust our timetables to reduce the amount of students attending on campus. At present, we're around 20% capacity, but we are looking at areas where we can reduce even further. It is clear we'll be under some level of restrictions for the foreseeable future. For that reason, it was agreed at Academic Council today that delivery and assessment would be in the same manner as it is now for the remainder of the academic year. This will give clarity to our students so that they can prepare themselves for the rest of the year. I know there's a lot of weirdness out there among staff and students and indeed the general public. We go through this again just as we were starting to adjust to the new safety precautions on campus. However, we must now assess our presence on campus, what is needed, and to ask anybody who can work from home to do so. For those who must attend on campus, I assure you we're doing all we can to create a safe working environment and are working in compliance with national guidelines. Should you feel your health and safety is compromised by working on site, please let me or your line manager know. As you're aware, the number of COVID cases in Sligo is at an all-time high. Undoubtedly, some of these cases are coming from our students. How many exactly, we cannot say, but we have been assured by our colleagues in public health that the numbers presenting themselves are a small percentage of the total cases in Sligo. All the more reason that we must remain at the highest alert and behave as if everyone, including ourselves, are carrying the virus. We must continue to keep our distance, wash our hands and wear a mask. The message is very simple, but difficult to keep going. If we do this, we can keep the virus at bay on campus, but of course, we will never eliminate it. We are working closely with the HSE and Public Health and are relying on them to inform us on what is the appropriate action to take. We will follow their expert advice throughout this pandemic. I want to take this opportunity to thank you all for the hard work and dedication you have shown yet again in your working flexibly and your resilience during this most surreal year. I really appreciate each and every effort you have made as many of us work from our homes again. I ask everyone to do what you can to support each other. We are all finding this very difficult and we cannot do this alone. So it's okay not to be okay. I would also ask you to look after our students. Many are finding this second lockdown very daunting and we must find new ways to engage with our students remotely. We have now moved from one campus to thousands of personal learning locations spread across the country. How do we adjust to this? And how do we engage, interact, and inspire our students when we are miles apart? If you have any ideas, please share them with us. Next week, we're holding our first online conferring ceremony. The Registrar's Office has been busy these past few months finding an alternative solution under the circumstances. It's unfortunate we can't celebrate this hugely enjoyable event in person, but I would ask you all to join in online. I would also like to suggest to the programme leads in each course to arrange a small online gathering of their own to mark our students' achievements. Away from COVID and lockdowns, we've had lots to celebrate in the past month. We've had received over 20 million euro in funding in a week, including over 12 million euro in an interesting research project into online learning with our CUA partners. We also received 5.7 million euro in our submission to become a technology university, which is now closer than ever. Finally, I want you to know my virtual door is always open to you. Please don't hesitate to contact me if you have any concerns. Take care and thank you again for your time, dedication and hard work.